is praying for you. This encourages me, because sometimes the burden can become so cumbersome that it feels as if you just can't make it. But it is so encouraging to know that someone somewhere, they may not even know your name, but the Holy Spirit puts your burden in their spirit, and they start to say things about you.
Shit!
fellowship with that person? Would you give them a word of encouragement? Hallelujah. Yeah, we thank the Lord. much. And we're getting ready to go home. But we have something very important that we wish to do. We have a baby that we want to dedicate, an infant. And we're going to ask the parents, the boy parents, to stand, please. And we're going to sing this song. Jesus loves the little children. All the children of the world. We want the grandmother to come, the grandparents, and the family that is here. We want you to come as well. Accept Jesus Christ as Savior. But we identify this family this morning as they make this public expression of their desire for this child to be drawn closer to God. I'm so happy to be accompanied by Minister Benby. He's going to come read the appropriate scripture and pray.
Chapter 10, verses 13 through 16. And they brought young children to him that he should touch them. And his disciples knew those that brought them. When Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. And he took them up in his arms, put his hands upon them, and he blessed them. Thank God for his word. Bow your heads. Father, we thank you for this occasion. We thank you, God, that the parents have remembered your word, that the young children should be brought unto you. We thank you, God, for young Gina McKinsey, who's going to be dedicated unto you right now. We pray, oh God, that your presence will be here even as we honor your word, that children should be brought unto you. Oh God, I pray, oh God, that they will be guided upon by your presence, Father. I pray this young child, Father, as she grows and waxes strong, Father, will give you praise and glory and honor, and at an early age, she will give her heart to you, O God, and be used for the honor and the glory of your name. We ask and submit that your perfect will be done right now in this service, that what you want done here today will be done. And that your name will be glorified as we do what you have sent us and called us to do this occasion. We thank you. We praise you. We worship you right now. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Minister Benaby. Dearly beloved, family is a divine institution ordained of God from the beginning of time. servant of the Lord, committed to him by their parents for care, protection, and training for his glory. It is meant that all parents recognize this obligation and their responsibility to God and his mother. Jochebed of old trained her own child Moses after having given him to the Lord. Hanna recognized that her child was Jehovah's. The Virgin Mary also brought the infant Jesus to the temple. Parents of this child likewise recognize the sacredness of their child and now bring back to the Lord the treasure which he has entrusted to them. In so doing, they, the parents, recognize and hereby publicly acknowledge their responsibility for the nurture and admonition of this child in the ways of righteousness and God peace. And we're now to the parents. And then you can say, we do. This isn't my questions. Modified. Do you promise to so conduct your own lives that this child may learn of the Lord Jesus Christ by your example? Say it loud. Do you promise to pray for this child daily?
Do.
You have a high key, who's smelling me. Won't pass out this movie must come. Do you promise to instruct this child in the ways of the Lord?
We do.
To teach? Let me finish, he's all excited now. Do you promise to instruct your child in the ways of the Lord? To teach her his word and to talk with her about faith in Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, so that when she reaches an age or reach an age of spiritual understanding, she will want to accept Jesus Christ as her Lord and Savior?
We do.
Amen. Congregation, would you stand please? And you don't have to be a member of this church, please stand. As a congregation, you've heard the promises of these parents, that they will be unable to achieve all their hopes and dreams for the enrichment of this child alone. Bringing up children is a community effort. For them to grow up to be all that they might be spiritually, emotionally, and physically, we will all have to help. And so I ask us as a congregation, do you promise to support the efforts of these parents with your prayers, your words and acts of encouragement? You want to say, we do, if you do. You sound a little weak, can you say it again?
We do.
Please be seated. My heads. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we bring this precious baby before you. Every child, Lord, that is conceived, you have a purpose and calling on the life of that person. God, the way of the world is to frustrate the divine process that you have for children and people in general. But we know, dear God, that you are a loving Savior and a loving friend and Father. And so we bring this baby before you, Lord, and we pray in the name of Jesus Christ that from this time forth, Lord, your presence will be over the life of this child. We pray, Lord, that there will always be food in the pantry, that there will be clothes in the closet. God, that there will be a nurturing environment for this child to come into our home. We come against abuse. We come against abandonment and neglect in any form. We pray, Father, that those who stand here today as witnesses, as godparents, that they will buttress this child, God, with love and care and warmth and concern. We thank you for the period of gestation. We thank you, Lord, that this pregnancy has ended in the delivery of this child. And we pray, Father, that one day this little baby or stand on some corner, would be in some building, would be in some environment, and would lift up the name of Jesus Christ, the Savior and His Lord. We thank you, Lord, in the name of the Father, name of the Son, name of the best Holy Spirit. God bless it. Take note, church. As we dedicate little Jacob, Azariah, and Kinsey, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son.